गुड मॉर्निंग गर्ल्स, वेलकम बैक टू द क्लासेस वंस अगेन। सो आई एम नॉट एबल टू सी द काइंड ऑफ रेस्पॉन्स वी यूज्ड टू गेट इन द बिफोर। सो आई एम रिक्वेस्टिंग ऑल द गर्ल्स, प्लीज केयरफुली लिसन ऑल द लेक्चर्स, गिव योर कमेंट्स सो दैट इट विल बी इंस्पायरिंग, इट विल बी गिविंग अ काइंड ऑफ मोटिवेशन टू ऑल द लेक्चर्स। So respond properly. Most of the people, they are not looking at the lectures or what we are teaching on the board. So I'm requesting all of you, look all the videos, give your comments. We are here to clear your doubts and see each and every video and make notes of it. So I'm telling you, now this is going to be a very, very important aspect as far as the practical exams are concerned. So now let us come to one more important concept. Now that will be called now applications of electric field. Now the first application we got, or the today's topic will be now applications of electric field. Now the first application we got, now let us say, now you got a horizontal electric field, or let us say you got a horizontal electric field of magnitude capital E. Now what I am doing, now I am keeping a positive charged particle Q at rest now inside the electric field. So now remember, now what is the application we got? So consider a horizontal electric field of magnitude capital E. Now what I am doing, now I am taking a positive charge Q and the charge will be kept at rest now inside the electric field. Now what is going to happen to the positive charge? The moment you are placing the charge now inside the electric field. So remember, the moment you are placing the charge now inside the electric field, now always remember the positive charge will be experiencing an electrostatic force now along the direction of the electric field, or remember the positive charge will be experiencing the electrostatic force now along the direction of the applied electric field. Now as a result, now what will happen? Now due to the electrostatic force, now the charged particle will be accelerated now inside the electric field. Now that's the reason why now the velocity of the particle will be keep on increasing now along with the time. So once again, now remember the important concept, the moment you are placing the positive charge, then remember now the positive charge will be experiencing the electrostatic force along the direction of the electric field. Now that is the reason why the particle will be accelerated now along the direction of the field. That's the reason why now the velocity of the particle will be keep on increasing now along with the time. So now now the first thing, now let us say now bit A. So now the bit A will be, now I want to find now what will be the uniform acceleration of the charged particle, or what will be the uniform acceleration of the charged particle now inside the electric field. So how to find the acceleration of the charged particle? Now the electrostatic force that will be experienced by the charged particle will be given by the formula Q into E. So you already know the electrostatic force that will be acting on the charged particle will be given by the formula F will be numerically equal to QE. And you also know from the Newton's second law, force will be numerically equal to mass into acceleration. So if I equate both the equations, so MA will be numerically equal to QE. So therefore the acceleration of the charged particle will be numerically equal to QE divided by M. So remember the important formula, the acceleration of the charged particle will be given by the formula. So A will be numerically equal to QE divided by M. So remember, that will be the uniform acceleration of the particle inside the electric field. So very simple to remember. Always remember the electrostatic force that will be acting on the positive charge will be given by the formula F will be numerically equal to QE. And we also know from the Newton's second law, F will be numerically equal to MA. I'm equating both of them. So MA will be numerically equal to QE. That is the reason why the acceleration of the charged particle will be numerically equal to QE divided by M. Then if you have taken the diagram, let us come to one more important bit. The second important bit. I want to obtain what will be the velocity of the particle. I want to find what will be the velocity of the particle as a function of time. Now I want to find what will be the velocity of the particle as a function of time. So how to obtain the final velocity, or how to obtain the final velocity of the particle as a function of time? So what I will do, I will apply the kinematical equation, V will be numerically equal to U plus AT. You already know the initial velocity of the particle will be numerically equal to 0. We already know Now the particle will be initially at rest. That's the reason why now the initial velocity of the particle will be equal to zero. And you already know now the acceleration of the particle will be given by the formula. Now we got now QE divided by M. Now then I am going to substitute in the formula for the velocity. Now let us see now what we are going to get. So therefore the final velocity will be numerically equal to now 0 plus 80. So therefore now final velocity will be numerically equal to now 0 plus 80. Now that is the reason why now final velocity of the particle will be numerically equal to 80. That's the reason why now final velocity will be numerically equal to, now you already know the acceleration will be now QE divided by M. So wherever I got acceleration, that will be QE divided by M into T, or I can write the velocity of the particle will be numerically equal to now QET now divided by M. So remember now this will be the velocity of the particle, or this will be the final velocity of the particle as a function of time, that will be given by the formula. So capital V will be numerically equal to now QET now divided by M. So remember now that is the second big figure. So we need to find now what will be the velocity that will be acquired by the particle now after a time t second. Now that will be given by now V will be numerically equal to now QET now divided by M. Then similarly now the third important bit. Now the third important bit. So now I want to find. So now the third important bit. Now I want to find. Now that will be now displacement of the particle. So I want to find now displacement of particle. Now displacement of particle as a function of time, or what will be that displacement of the particle as a function of time. So very simple, in order to obtain the displacement, now which a kinematical equation I can apply in order to obtain that displacement covered by the particle. Now after a time t second, I can apply the kinematical equation. Now S will be numerically equal to now ut plus half at square. But you already know now the initial velocity will be zero. So therefore the displacement of the particle will be numerically equal to half at square. But you already know now what is the acceleration of the particle. So acceleration of the particle will be QE divided by M. Now what I will do, I will incorporate the value of acceleration. That's the reason why the displacement of the particle will be numerically equal to now half into now QE divided by M now multiplied by T square. So now therefore if I simplify now what I am going to get, now remember the formula for velocity, now QET now divided by M. So now if I further now simplify, so the displacement of the particle now will be given by the formula now QET square now divided by 2m. So simply now what you do, now open the bracket, so that displacement that will be covered by the particle as a function of time will be given by the formula, so S will be numerically equal to now QE T square now divided by 2m. So remember now that will be the displacement of the particle as a function of time. Now similarly I want to find the fourth important bit. So I want to find now the fourth important bit. Now that will be the kinetic energy of the particle, or what will be the kinetic energy of the particle as a function of time. Now let us see now how to obtain the formula for the kinetic energy of the particle as a function of time. So you already know now what is the formula for the kinetic energy. So kinetic energy will be given by the formula now half m into v square. But just now we already saw now what will be the velocity of the particle. So velocity of the particle will be given by now QET now divided by M. Now already I obtained the velocity of the particle. So if you remember now the velocity of the particle or the speed of the particle will be given by the formula. So V will be numerically equal to now QET now divided by M. Now what you do, now substitute the value of V in the above equation, or you substitute the value of velocity in the above equation. So what we are going to get, so now let us see now what we are going to get, or what will be the kinetic energy of the particle as a function of time. So I can write now K will be numerically equal to half m. Now velocity will be given by the formula now QET divided by m whole square. If I simplify the kinetic energy of the charged particle will be given by now half m now Q square E square T square now divided by m square. Now what I can cancel, and m and m will be getting cancelled. Now that is the reason why the kinetic energy of the charged particle will be given by the formula now Q square E square T square now divided by 2m. Or now remember, so the kinetic energy of the charged particle will be given by the formula now Q K will be numerically equal to now q square e square t square now divided by 2m. So remember now that will be now another bit of a god. So what will be the kinetic energy of the charged particle as a function of time? So remember the kinetic energy of the particle as a function of time will be given by the formula. Now k will be numerically equal to q square e square t square now divided by 2m. So remember now that will be the kinetic energy of the charged particle as a function of time. Now similarly, now one more important thing or one more important bit I want to find. Now in the same concept, I want to find now one more important thing. Now let us see now what is now another important thing. So now I want to find that de Broglie wavelength. So I want to find now what will be the de Broglie wavelength of the particle, de Broglie wavelength of the particle as a function of time. So now let us see. So now one more very good important concept we got. So now I want to obtain the expression, or now I want to obtain the expression for the de Broglie wavelength of the particle as a function of time. So now if you remember last year, or if you remember now what is the formula for the de Broglie wavelength, or if you remember, now what is the formula for the de Broglie wavelength of any material particle? Now you already know that de Broglie wavelength of any material particle will be given by the formula. So lambda will be numerically equal to h divided by v. So you already know now that de Broglie wavelength for any material particle will be given by the formula. So lambda will be numerically equal to now h divided by now mass into velocity. Now you already know the velocity of the particle. Now substitute the velocity in the above equation. So what you are going to get, now very simple. Now substitute the formula for the velocity. Now what you are going to get, now you already know the velocity of the charged particle will be given by the formula. Now QET now divided by M. Now what you do, now you cross multiply. So therefore now mass into velocity or the momentum of the charged particle will be given by the formula. Now QED. So what I am doing, now directly I am cross multiplying mass. That's the reason why the momentum of the charged particle or the magnitude of the momentum of the charged particle will be given by the formula. So mv will be numerically equal to qed. Now what you do? Now wherever you got MV or wherever you got the momentum of the charged particle, now substitute the momentum will be numerically equal to QED. So therefore, the de Broglie wavelength of the charged particle will be given by H divided by, now we got MV, so MV will be given by QE into T. So remember, now this will be the formula we got for the de Broglie wavelength of the charged particle as a function of time, or this will be the formula we got for the de Broglie wavelength of the charged particle as a function of time. Now, similarly, now continuing the same concept, so now I want to find what will be the rate, change of the de Broglie wavelength, or now I want to find what will be the rate change of the de Broglie wavelength. So rate change of the de Broglie wavelength. So now, the next important thing, so I want to find what will be the rate change of the de Broglie wavelength. Now what do you mean by the rate change of the de Broglie wavelength? Now remember, now the rate change of the de Broglie wavelength will be denoted by d lambda divided by ED. So meaning what? Now rate change of the de Broglie wavelength is nothing but d by dt of the de Broglie wavelength, or the differentiation of the de Broglie wavelength with respect to time will be generally called the rate change of the de Broglie wavelength. So remember, now the rate change of the de Broglie wavelength will always be defined d by dt of lambda, or the differentiation of the wavelength with respect to time will be generally called the rate change of the de Broglie wavelength. So we need to find what is the value of d lambda divided by dt. So what I need to do? Now I need to differentiate the wavelength on both the side with respect to time. So now what I can write? Now d by dt of lambda. Now de Broglie wavelength you already got. Now de Broglie wavelength will be given by H divided by QED, or de Broglie wavelength will be given by H divided by QED. So if I differentiate, now let us see what you are going to get. By differentiating on the right hand side. So therefore, d lambda divided by dt will be numerically equal to, take the constants outside, and the differentiation will always be done for the variable. Take the constants outside, and that differentiation will always be done for the variable. So what are the constants we got? So H divided by Q QE can be taken outside. Now what will be left over? Now what is left over? Now d by dt of 1 by t. So now this can be further written. Now d lambda divided by dt will be numerically equal to now h by QE. Now you already know now differentiation of 1 by t will be numerically equal to minus 1 by t square. That's the reason why now d lambda divided by dt will be numerically equal to now what I am going to get now minus h now divided by now QE into t square. So remember now that will be the formula we got, or that will be the expression we got for the rate change of the de Broglie of wavelength, or that is the expression we got for the rate change of the de Broglie wavelength that will be given by now d lambda divided by dt will be numerically equal to minus h now divided by now QE into t square. So remember now that will be the first application we got, or that will be the first application we got for the uniform electric field. Now once you have understood this particular concept, now let us take now one more application. Now once you have taken this concept, now let us take now one more application. Now based on the uniform electric field, now another fantastic concept, excellent concept we got as the application of the electric field. So now let us see now one more application. Now that will be now application on number 2 for the uniform electric field. Now listen carefully. Now what I am doing, now very important application you got. So listen, now what I am doing, now let us say now you got a pendulum box. Now let us say now you got a pendulum box, which is let us say you got a pendulum box of mass m that will be suspended by a light string from a rigid support. So now very simple, now what I am doing, now I am taking a pendulum box of mass m, and the box will be suspended by a light string from a rigid support. Now let us say the pendulum box has been given a positive charge, or let us say the pendulum box has been given a positive charge Q, and let us say now we are applying a uniform electric field now acting in the horizontal direction. So now listen carefully. Now what I am telling you, now listen very carefully. Now what I am telling you, so very important application. So a very important application. Now let us say, now consider a simple pendulum, or consider a pendulum box of mass m that will be suspended from a light string from a rigid support. Now let us say the pendulum box will be given a positive charge Q and let us say a horizontal electric field of magnitude capital E will be applied, or let us say a horizontal electric field of magnitude capital E will be applied. So now I want to find now what will be the angle that will be made by the string with the vertical now under the equilibrium position, or now I want to find now what will be the angle that will be made by the string with the vertical. So now can you tell me now the moment we are applying the electric field, now what is going to happen on the pendulum box? So now remember, now what are the forces that will be acting on the pendulum box, or what are the forces that will be acting on the pendulum box? So very simple, now one will be, so you already know, now one force will be the weight of the box will always be acting in the vertical direction. So one external force that will be acting on the pendulum box, now weight will be acting vertically downward. Now apart from that, now what are the other forces? Now the other forces will be, now already I told you, a positive charge. Now remember, a positive charge will be experiencing an electrostatic force QE now along the direction of the electric field. Now remember, a positive charge will always be experiencing an electrostatic force now along the direction of the applied electric field. So one force will be, so now one force will be, the weight will be acting vertically downward, the electrostatic force will be acting along the horizontal, and what is one more force that will be acting on the box? Now remember, there is one more force that will be acting on the box, and that will be the tension in the string, and the tension will always be acting not towards the point of suspension, or remember that tension force will always be acting not towards the point of suspension. So remember, now what are the forces that will be acting on the bob under equilibrium position? Or remember, now what are the forces that will be acting on the pendulum box? Now what are the forces that will be acting on the pendulum box under equilibrium position? Now one will be the weight of the box will be acting vertically downward. Now the second one, the electrostatic force will always be acting along the direction of the electric field, or remember, the positive charge will always be experiencing the electrostatic force now along the direction of the electric field. So one more force that will be acting on the bob will be the electrostatic force QE that will be acting along the horizontal. And now one more force that will be acting on the pendulum box is nothing but the tension in the string. And remember, not tension or will always be acting not towards the point of suspension, or the tension will always be acting not towards the point of suspension. So now you can clearly see, now under the equilibrium, now the string will be making an angle theta with the vertical, or under the equilibrium, now the string will be making an angle theta with the equilibrium. So now I want to find, now what will be the value of theta. Now first bit I want to find, now find the angle theta. So first I want to find out, now what will be the angle that will be made by the string with the vertical, or what will be the angle that will be made by the string with the vertical, now under the equilibrium position. So for that, now what I need to do, now very simple, now what you do, now resolve tension into two perpendicular components, or resolving the tension into two perpendicular components. Now you already know this angle will be theta, that's the reason why. Now this angle will be 90 degree, so the remaining angle will be 90 minus theta. So this angle will be theta, this will be 90 degree, so the remaining angle will be 90 minus theta. So now if you look at the diagram, you can clearly see, now tension will be making an angle 90 minus theta with the horizontal, or the tension force will be making an angle 90 minus theta with the horizontal. So now what I will do, I will resolve the tension into two perpendicular components. Now what will be the horizontal component? The horizontal component will be not T cos of 90 minus theta, and you already know, now cos 90 minus theta will be sin theta. That's the reason why, now remember, the horizontal component will be given by, now T cos of 90 minus theta. That's the reason why the horizontal component will be numerically equal to T sin theta. Now similarly, now what is the vertical component? Now similarly, now what is the vertical component of the tension? So vertical component of the tension will be given by, now T sine of 90 minus theta. So sine 90 minus theta will be numerically equal to cos theta. That's the reason why the vertical component will be numerically equal to, now T cos theta. So now if you look at the free body diagram, now this is the pendulum box. Now what are the forces that will be acting on the pendulum bob? So if I draw the free body diagram, so you already know the weight will be acting vertically downward, and similarly now T cos theta will be acting vertically upward. Now along the horizontal, now QE will be acting towards the right side, and similarly now towards the left side, now T sin theta will be acting. So you can clearly see now what is the free body diagram on the pendulum bob. Now along the vertical, now weight will be acting in the downward direction, and T cos theta will be acting in the upward direction. Now similarly along the horizontal, now QE will be acting towards the right side, and T sin theta will be acting towards the left side. Now let us see now what will happen under equilibrium. So now I can say now what will be happening now under equilibrium. So remember, now under equilibrium, now upward force will be balancing now downward force, or under the equilibrium, now the net vertical force will become zero, now meaning the upward force will be balancing the downward force, and QE will be balancing now T sin theta. So therefore, now under equilibrium, so what I can write? So I can write now along the vertical, now T cos theta will be numerically equal to mg, and along the horizontal, now I can write now T sin theta will be numerically equal to QE. Now let us say now equation number 2. Now what I will do, now I will divide 2 by 1. So if I remove the diagram, now what I will do, now divide now equation 2 by equation 1, so divide 2 by 1, so what we get, now T sin theta now divided by T cos theta will be numerically equal to, now what we are going to get, now QE now divided by MG, so tension and tension will be getting cancelled, so sin theta divided by cos theta will be tan theta, so tan theta will be numerically equal to now QE divided by MG, so therefore the angle theta will be numerically equal to now tan inverse of QE now divided by MG. So therefore now this will be the angle of deflection, or this will be the angle that will be made by the string with the vertical now under the equilibrium position, or this will be the angle of deflection of the string with respect to vertical now under the equilibrium position.